You are listening to Con Talk, and this is episode number 26, where we're going to be discussing Wild Nights 2014, which took place, well, actually, before I get started, let me introduce my co-host for this episode, who is making his podcast debut for the first time ever. Say hi to the nice people, WolfBoy. Okay, Oh, okay. I see. Speak English, man. This is America.
America. Is this better?
Yeah, I guess that'll work.
Do I have to swallow the cough drop a bit?
I'll edit it out.
Okay. Oh, no. We're fine. We're fine.
No, we're fine. I'll edit it out.
Welcome to podcast. A 104.7 YFFM.
Yeah,
Beats feel so good, you want to be stuck to us all night long. Is that good?
Yeah, this one's going to take extra long to edit.
Is it?
Oh, I don't know. I'm just being silly.
Okay.
All right, so Wild Nights took place. Was it last weekend? Hasn't been that long. Yeah,
It's been a little bit. Last weekend.
Last weekend. April 24th through the 27th at Robbers Cave State Park near Wilburton, Oklahoma. For perspective, this is Wolfboy's second trip, correct?
Yes, it is.
Your last time was what, 2010? It was before the big nasty storm thing.
Yeah, it was 2010.
2010, yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, and this was actually my first time at this event, though I have been to Oklacon previously, which is another outdoor convention that's also held in Oklahoma.
Yeah, I do have to mention, though, this was the first time I actually had a suit. I didn't have a fursuit when I went in 2010.
Okay, so it doesn't count? You get an asterisk?
I get an asterisk on that one. I wasn't full-on furry yet, I guess.
Okay, well, I guess I get an asterisk, too, then.
An asterisk.
There's something I could say, but I'm not going to say it.
Go for it.
You mean like the Spurs and the strike shirt and suit? Oh yeah, I went there, sports boy.
Just a bitter Cowboys fan. When was the last time you won a championship?
Anyway, yeah, you're listening to two of the 10 nerds that actually give a shit about sports.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so there we are. Wild Nights, of course, is a furry convention, and just like Oklacon, it's also an outdoor furry convention, which is a bit different in that, you know, there are more activities that you do outside. You don't have to worry about, there's no hotel involved. You know, and in this case, there really wasn't, because at Oklacon, and I'm going to do a lot of kind of comparing between the two, at Oklacon, they actually have like a little lodge thing, which is basically a hotel where you could stay at if you want. But in this case, you know, there's like, well, you have your choice of cabins, which you stayed in,
mm-hmm.
and or you can sleep in a tent, which I did,
yes,
with some friends,
mm-hmm.
and so you have your choice, you know, as far as how much you want to rough it.
Yeah, how was the tent?
You know, the tent was fine. The weather was actually pretty cooperative.
This is true
for the most part, up until we had to leave. Mm-hmm. But we'll get to that, you know, when we get to it.
Yeah, the cabins were really nice. I mean,
yeah, I was impressed.
Yeah, in 2010, they didn't have any of the AC systems. What they did have was box fans that you could use, but they didn't have any little, you know, wall, what do you call it, window units?
Right.
So they didn't have any of those.
Okay, it was just fans and that was it. But mm-hmm. now we've upgraded to,
yeah, you know, we have two AC systems. Well, it depends on the cabin. If they're the smaller ones, it just had one in there.
Yeah, but even then, that's something.
Oh, yeah.
But even then, that first night, dude, was like 50 degrees outside. It's like, why did you turn on the air conditioner? It was cold as shit.
Because the building's holding a lot of heat. You put 30 people in a small not even an A-frame. It's a small building. You're creating a lot of heat.
Yeah, they crammed a lot of people in those buildings.
Yeah.
But even then, I mean, as a whole, there's really not, as far as attendance goes, and I don't think we got any official numbers from the event.
No, because we left before closing ceremonies.
Yeah, but I think it was my best guess is attendance was probably 200 225.
Low 200. I think that's a very good estimate. I'm going to say about 220 to 230. Yeah.
So, yeah, I mean, we're from San Antonio, or we're in San Antonio, rather. So, yeah, I mean, we drove the whole, 400, 500 miles.
Yeah, which wasn't too bad. There,
which was nice. I mean, it was, you know.
It was far more exciting once you leave Texas.
Yeah, which takes all of, four of those 5 hours.
No, it feels far longer than that. Texas always feels far longer.
That's true, and that's because you weren't the one driving, so. So there we are.
Dogs can't drive.
Nope, not unless they're on a leash.
You sure about that?
Oh, I don't know. Outdoor convention. So one of the things that's a little bit different about it, two of the things actually, is that number one, your accommodations are already covered in the cost of the event. You know, for example, an Oklacon was actually an extra per day charge for the tent. And we didn't have that here. It was just, you know, the normal registration fee. And also they provide meals. I believe it was two meals per day that they prepared, breakfast and...
No, it was three.
Yeah, I was going to say.
Because they had breakfast, lunch, and dinner. The times of which were a little sketchy.
Yeah, and that would be probably my first, you know, complaint about the event, was that the mealtime scheduling was definitely, you had to give them like a half hour, 1 hour.
Oh, no, it was more than that.
Really?
There was a couple days it was 2 hours off. I mean, that's going to be expected. I mean, you're trying to serve to 200 plus people, and you're running with volunteers and...
Yeah, but my counter argument to that is this isn't the first time they've done this. You know what I mean?
In 2010, it was the exact same deal, and it was with only 120 people there that year. So it is just, it's furries running a con.
Herding cats?
Herding cats?
Yeah, you never heard the expression herding cats? No. You never saw the EDS commercial?
No. No.
You are dead to me.
I'm sorry.
But yeah, herding cats is basically, when you're trying to take charge of people that, you know, generally don't listen or pay attention, like computer programmers or furries or whatever, it's referred to as herding cats.
Oh, I see.
And you just learned something today.
Ooh. Yay! I'm always learning things.
That's our wolf boy. It's very, you know, once you get over the drive, it's very cost efficient. You know, if you don't mind a whole outside thing.
Yeah, I think honestly, it's the cheapest con that you can go to.
Yeah, I'll agree with
because
that.
Because for the, what is it, the 40, 45? $50 for the registration, your meals are covered for the most part, unless you're wanting snacks. I mean, accommodations free instead of paying $100 a night for a hotel.
Mm-hmm. So you're paying like, what, 15 bucks a day? I don't think that would even cover your daily meals at a regular hotel convention.
Oh, no, because what I mean? Everybody has to go to Fogo de Chao, Tokyo One, and
Let It Go, man.
Chili's, and, you know, when you go to
Chili's.
Oh, there's nothing wrong with it, but it's still a place that it's like 15 bucks just to eat there for that one meal out of the three that you're at the con, you know, for that day. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Like, TFF is like the most expensive con food-wise that I always go to. Let's go to the melting pot. That's $60, fool.
$60 of sadness, I believe.
Yes, yes, it was $60 of sadness and sitting there for over 3 hours.
Yeah, 3 hours. When you could have been, you know, roaming around the hotel being
drunk. I could have been getting drunk for free.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, you go to a room party.
Oh, okay, there you go. Yeah,
see? I'd rather hang out with more people having fun than sitting there front-faced because you're waiting for an hour for food.
Well, lessons learned and all that, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. We're going to stay with, Boston Market and Waffle House.
I still haven't been to Waffle House.
You need to go.
We'll definitely go next year.
Yes.
Yeah, you know, because Boston Market has become your quote-unquote unofficial birthday meal.
Birthday meal.
It always falls around that time.
And it's good. And it's only like, what, 12 bucks?
Yeah.
And that's usually one of my better meals there, to be quite honest.
Yeah, I mean, I certainly can't argue with it.
Mm-mm.
Anyway, getting back to Wild Nights, and we're really hungry, you know, in case you can't tell.
Dairy Queen.
Dairy Queen, yes. Dip cones for all.
Peanut Buster Parfait.
I'm not quite that hungry, but yeah. I have to say, in terms of, it's kind of funny because, you know, going back to the Oklacon versus Wild Nights thing, Oklacon seems to be better organized as a convention, but Wild Nights has much better facilities.
Yes.
At the Robbers Cave State Park. everything was nice. I mean,
I could make a counterpoint on the organization, because who would have a con where you have to pretty much drive to get to certain events?
Yeah, but
that's like, derp, what were we thinking?
Yeah, but that's a consequence of the location they picked.
Well, then they shouldn't have picked that location.
Ooh. I'll give you that, but, you know, they do the best with what they have. You know. Fail. God, and here I thought I was going to be the devil's advocate.
Mm. You're talking to a werewolf. What do you expect?
I don't know. I don't know which wolf I'm talking to.
You want me to go into Dirt Wolf for the rest of this interview?
It's your voice.
Ugh, I don't want to
or lack thereof once you're done.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, let's not do that.
Robert's Cave State Park, where they hold it, is very nice. We basically take up the entire, one of the group camps, group camp number 2, if I remember correctly. And like I said, it's nice, bathrooms and cabin, and there's plenty of space to put tents, you know, and all that good stuff.
And another nice thing is the parking. I mean, you could park right in front of your tent.
Yes.
How much, I mean, the convenience nice. Of that, that you can't beat that. Oh, I need to go get a soda. Okay, let me just go to my car. You know?
Oh, I left my fursuit in the car. And it's a lot of pop.
Well, you have to do that with even with a tent, you only have so much space in a tent. So you realistically, and that's the other thing you kind of have to get used to is just thousands of dollars of stuff just sitting out in the open is hard to get used to. I mean, if you got a fursuit, see, like you have a Don't Hug Cacti, or if you have a lacy suit, or
now for the uninitiated, for the uninitiated, those are really high end.
Yeah, the Mercedes Benz and Bentleys of fursuits. I mean, you wear one of those and it's like $3,500, and you're like, if you're just setting it out there, I mean, imagine if somebody takes that.
And I can see that. I left my laptop and my iPad in my vehicle for the lion's share of the trip.
Yeah. So anything of value, I usually just kind of keep in a vehicle, just to be safe.
You know, and in your defense, you know, I should have brought the damn keys, because I was thinking about it before I left. Mm-hmm. So I should have get the other set of keys. Nah. Mm-hmm. Oh wait, fursuiter.
Mm-hmm.
Fail.
Yeah.
Once again, lessons learned for next year.
Oh, and another thing, the showers are really good there too.
Leave the fursuiter at home. Yeah.
Leave the fursuiter at home.
I learned my lesson. Yeah.
No, you don't leave the fursuiter at home, because then you have a lack of entertainment. You wouldn't have had a monster truck to take pictures of.
I
have
nature. I don't need entertainment.
There wasn't enough entertainment in the nature until, what was it, Saturday and going into Sunday when we got attacked by pollen.
Oh, dear God. That was for the whole thing.
Oh, it was bad on, it was really bad on Saturday, though. Just when the wind started kicking up. Because it wasn't horrible on Thursday. Friday was a little, and then Saturday, when that wind kicked up, woo.
I don't remember if it was Friday or Saturday morning, but I'm just sitting at camp, you know, just taking it easy, probably listening to the radio
Saturday, whatever.
Yeah, Saturday morning, just sitting around. And this is something I kind of had to get used to, because I'm from the flatlands where we don't have real trees that go straight up and down like they do there. Was, you know, hearing the wind blowing through the trees. So I hear the wind blowing through the trees. I kind of just look up out of morbid curiosity, and I just see a cloud, giant yellow cloud, just descend from the trees. And I was like, oh, hell no. You know, because I was getting over some pretty gnarly allergies that I picked up here in good old San Antonio.
And the tree was like, oh, hell yeah.
I have to say though that the park, you know, was very nice.
Mm-hmm.
I like that.
And if you climb Robert's Cave State Park, get cell phone reception.
Yeah, reception was like zero at the camp and surrounding the camp. But there's the whole impetuous behind the Robert's Cave State Park is that there's a cave that was allegedly used by ne'er-do-wells, you know, criminals, crooks, what have yous, back in the day, you know, like 1800s or whatever. They have, you know, nice little, you know, trails and this. You know, you could take the scenic route and take the, you know, the careful, well-worn trail that normal people do, or you can just, oh, fuck it, let's just go straight up the thing like we did.
Yeah, that was fun. When we climbed it. Yeah. Oh, no, what was worse was heading back down. We took the, what was that called, the devil's slide back down?
Yeah, there was like an easy trail and a hard trail.
And we took the extremely hard trail back down.
Well, we had poor Akari, you know, trying to not fall down.
Atari.
I told you about the you fail at girl thing, right? Mm-mm. Yeah, so apparently Furball got something stuck in his ear overnight.
Oh, the earbud. Yeah, he got an earbud stuck in his ear.
Yeah, because he slept with them on.
Mm-hmm.
And so he needed, you know, he's looking for a pair of tweezers to pull it out. And he asked me, and I said, you know, I'm sorry, dude, I don't have one. You know what? We have a girl in our group. Ask her. You know, certainly a woman would have things like tweezers and nail clippers and all this and that in her purse. And she let us down.
Instead, she handed you a copy of Pitfall and E.T.
But yeah, I was like, really? And she had the big old giant bag in front of her, too. I was like, really? You, in all that, you do not have a... No, I don't have a thing of tweezers. You fail at girl. I was right. I was right. There are no female furries.
Yeah, that's that's a first. Every girl.
Mahadri did have the tweezers.
Mm-hmm. See, yeah, Furball needed those headphones at night to listen to soothing nature sounds, even though he's in nature.
Fun times.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but yeah, I mean, I'd say another kind of point of contention for me personally, you know, because I tend to overanalyze these things or whatever, or we'll see if you agree or not, was the registration took too long.
Yeah, and it usually does, is because just the amount of volunteers, because not only do you have registration going on, but they're also trying to cook a meal.
Yeah, but it's not the same people.
True. You know, I mean, it's just based upon how many volunteers they get, and
I'll give you that for the kitchen, but for the registration, I personally think it might be an internet thing that they don't have good internet.
That was probably another one.
But yeah, I mean, that's something they could probably work on.
Mm-hmm.
Now, you know, going back to the food thing, the food was flipping awesome. You know, I thought, dude, compared to what you usually get, which is nothing, or Cheetos in the con lounge or whatever. Come on.
The crepes. The crepes were good. Yeah, those chocolate crepes were good.
Chocolate strawberry.
Mm-hmm.
Those were good. Which I never had crepes in my life.
Really? Even the Nutella ones that they sell at IHOP? You've never taken advantage of those?
I didn't know what crepes were.
Crepes.
Dude, Mexican, come on.
You should feel at home with them because they're little roll dough thingies. They look like little breakfast tacos, but from another country.
Yeah, France.
Yeah. Yeah, France and their
crepes.
France and their freedom fries.
Yeah, I went there.
Mm-hmm.
But no, we had crepes. We had, was it potato soup?
That was the other problem.
Oh, boy.
Oh, okay. But
no, that's fair.
They didn't make enough food for the people there. It was like, yeah, let me get my potato soup. Wait. No, what? What was the one? It was a beef stew with no beef. It just had some vegetables in it. I felt so bad for Mahadre that I went out and, like, sat there and sifted through the bowl of nothingness for the better part of 10 minutes to get him something that was more substantial than the broth that he had beforehand.
Oh, poor guy.
Yeah.
I kind of just dealt with it. I mean, you know, it's not like I need to eat a lot anyway.
Mm-hmm.
So I just grabbed what I could and didn't get all hung up on, there's no beef in this beef stew.
Yeah, that was me.
You know, well, and that's a legitimate complaint.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and it may go back to the whole, you know, they weren't prepared for that many people.
As much crap as they were unloading off that truck, and I had to help them unload off the truck, they were pretty damn prepared. I think they just miscalculated how many people were actually going to be eating. I don't know. There's nothing in town other than McDonald's and Sonic.
And let's go ahead and go there, because this really bothered us. The grocery stores have failed that closed at 8 o'clock.
Mm-hmm.
Oh God, that was so hilarious.
Yeah. What town has everything close up at 8?
I'm from a small town in Texas. We don't even shut down at 8 o'clock.
Oh, I'm from a small town in Virginia, and we don't close down at 8 o'clock. Nothing. I mean, the mall stays open till 9, you know, your big retail stores.
We don't even have a mall.
Yeah.
We're just a little rinky-dink town like that little rinky-dink town. And our stuff stayed, you know, the grocery store always stayed open until 9.
You know, we always had a liquor store that stayed open till midnight. And this one closed at 9. It wasn't even 9. It was 8.
It was barely a liquor store. Come on, man.
You barely.
The skeeviest thing I think I've ever seen in my life.
Yeah, what used to be an old gas station from probably back in the 50s. And it looks
because it had a garage.
Mm-hmm. I mean, they didn't even use the garage. It was just the inside of this little gas station. Stuff just stacked everywhere. It was better than nothing, though.
Small towns. Gotta love them.
Mm-hmm. Welcome to Radiator Springs.
So true.
Mm-hmm.
Where life comes to a standstill.
Ka-chow!
I want to see that now.
Oh, it's a good movie.
Nothing really major, but just little, you know, things that I guess could be worked on or whatnot. You know, more volunteers or planning or...
The town could be leveled and rebuilt as a new town that will actually stay open till 9.
Well, I was talking about the con, but okay, if we're going to go there, then, yeah. You going to be all right, man?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I'm just thinking about that stupid town that I'll never, ever think about living in.
I'm from, you know, a little town in Texas, so it even threw me.
Mm-hmm.
Because I would expect, okay, 9 o'clock, everything, you know, shuts down. We're done. But even I was like, 8? Really? The grocery store?
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I think at one point when we were at Dollar General, which mercifully was actually open, I think I even said, is dancing forbidden in this town? Is this like the town where Footloose took place?
Mm-hmm. It was bad. It was
definitely a little bit of culture shock.
I'm surprised the Sonic didn't close down at 8 o'clock or something. I'm sorry, we're closed.
Yeah, no, I think the Pizza Hut stayed open too.
Yeah. Yeah, I went to that Pizza Hut back in 2010. It was a good Pizza Hut.
My only disappointment was that the donut shop wasn't open.
Oh, yeah, that had closed down.
Oh.
It was closed down.
Yeah, I know. That made me sad face because you see a sign that says donut shop, and you get excited, and it's like, oh, no donuts.
Hmm. The funny thing is, if it was in Texas, that donut shop would have turned into a Jalisco like 2 weeks later.
Oy! Orale! Mm-hmm. Tacos for everybody.
3 tacos, $1.99.
Mm-hmm. See, that's what I'm used to, not this crepes, whatever the fuzz
creeps.
It is.
Creeps. Creeps. They're good.
Creeps for the creeps.
Mm-hmm. Creeps for the creeps.
But no, speaking of creeps, I was a little disappointed in the lack of fursuiters. You know, there weren't very many. That's, you know.
Well, it's one. It's a small con. Two, again, we're one outdoors.
And that's what I was about to say. I figured that had something to do with it.
Then another one, the cost of the fursuit itself. Do you really think people were going to get those dirty? A lot of them, they're like, oh my god, dirt, you know.
Hmm.
I mean, that's kind of why I wear the shoes for dirt. It keeps them from getting dirty.
There were a few, you know, but for the most part, yeah, I mean, it was pretty, you know, barren as far as suitors go. And I thought it was funny that, I don't know if you looked at the schedule, but they actually had a fursuit parade scheduled for Sunday.
Oh, that wasn't going to happen.
And I was like, really? They're going to just, like, walk around in a circle around the fire pit or something?
I don't know, because I didn't stick around for it on Sunday in 2010, so I don't remember anything about that on Sunday.
Yeah, it was on the schedule. That's all.
What time was it scheduled for, out of curiosity?
I want to say 12, but that's a guess.
Oh, so during the thunderstorm that was in... And there goes 4 fursuiters flying away! Uh-oh. And yeah. Jeffrey Fox was never seen again.
Yeah, I bet it was an interesting day in Oz that day.
Mm-hmm. Dramatic tornado shit storms.
Oh, God, the radio.
Mm-hmm.
I took the liberty of bringing one of those crank radios, and it all, you know, just have something to listen to. And also it has the weather stations, you know, the NOAA computer voice, blah, blah, blah. And apparently y'all got really bored. Started listening to it, and at one point, I'll let you continue.
Well, I was around for the end of that. You guys told me about it.
Okay, well, I wasn't even there when it first happened. I was mm-hmm. like, I forget what I was doing, but I wasn't there. I just know as like I had come back to camp, and everybody's just giggling their ass off like they're, you know, 10 years old, and somebody just said, you know, fart or something. And I was like, what the hell? I was like, well, dude, just listen to this. And, you know, of course, the weather thing loops. Because they only change it every so often. And somewhere down the line, the weather computer, and later we figured out what it was supposed to be saying, But apparently it's a chance of tornado shitstorms.
I think that's pretty good way of getting people's attention.
Well, it definitely got ours, because I think we listen more to the damn weather station than the actual music stations.
Mm-hmm.
Which, for the record, a majority of which were country, talk, and suck. You know, so, yeah.
Mostly suck.
Well, I was so happy when I finally found a classic rock station. It's like, nobody touched this dial. I do not want to hear anything else but this one halfway okay, you know, K-Zep, you know, plays the same 20 songs over and over again station. That was definitely a source of entertainment, so bring your weather radios, if nothing else.
You never know when there's going to be dramatic tornado shitstorms.
I think Furball actually taped the...
Oh, yeah, he did.
I think he has the audio. I don't know if he's...
That and we filmed Jiffy Pop.
Did you? Was it? I think
that... Remember? He filmed the Jiffy Pop. Because that was so much entertainment for us on Friday. Was it even on Friday? I think that was on Thursday.
Yeah, that was the fail. That was the fail Jiffy Pop.
Yeah. Oh wow, Jiffy Pop.
The heat on the stove was too high, so it started burning fairly quickly, and before most of the stuff even popped, it was like, "Ooh, big puffy Jiffy Pop thing! Yay, popcorn!"
Popcorn.
Nothing popped, and it's burnt and stuck to the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
Never mind, guys. We'll try again tomorrow, and we
did, and it worked.
The second time it worked. Now, luckily, I don't think the unveiling came out in the video, so. So I'm good. I had a lot of fun, even though I didn't do a lot of the con stuff. I went to, I think, like one panel, the writer meetup, you know, meet the other creepy writers at Write Smut. actually that only happened the first time. It hasn't really happened since. But
well, that's good. I mean, it's kind of...
No, because I missed the hat-making panel. I wanted a hat. I wanted a Robin Hood hat with a big feather in it.
Robin Hood hats are overrated.
You just don't know.
I just don't know.
Stupid dog.
It's because I have like 20 hats already. Half of them sitting in my car right now. Is that the problem? I just already have too many hats. So I don't care about another one.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You become jaded in your mm-hmm. hat excess.
Yeah, the hat excess is to hide the pointy ears.
Look at me, I'm a doggy.
Well, if I take off the nose on the suit, it's a bat.
Oh, this is true.
Mm-hmm. What sound does a bat make? Bat! Bat! Bat!
Fun times.
Drunken adventures.
Yes, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Your drunken adventures, and later my connecting the dots of your drunken adventures to angry mutual friends.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, God, that was fun.
I do my best.
You do well, sir.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, like I said, overall, I'd call it a good event. I mean, I had fun. It was more like a camping trip that just happened to have some furry stuff with it.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yeah, and I enjoy those more. I
think maybe you've been in the game a little too long and the things are repeating themselves.
It's not really that. When you go to a con, especially a fur con, if you're a fursuiter, I think you have this expectation of like, well, I gotta get into it and I gotta do this and I gotta do X, Y, Z, and then I gotta go hang out with this group and then this group. And then we're going to go eat dinner at 6. It's always the same thing. You go to a camping con or an anime con, and things are a little more loose. It's just, I'll see if I feel like it.
You don't feel as obligated to play the crowd, maybe?
Yeah, and the other thing with a fur con is everybody's a damn fursuiter. So you have to go out of your way to get the attention. And I don't mind doing that, but it's work. You know, you turn it into a job almost. Whereas if you go to an anime convention or something that's a little more laid back, like this was, because there weren't many, you know, fursuiters around.
You're special.
You're special. And you just stand there and look pretty. And people want to take pictures. And that's, you know, I kind of enjoy that because there's that, a nice lack of effort.
just show up and look pretty.
Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, it's nice. It's a little more laid back.
Oh, okay.
And the other thing is, since I'm just standing there, I'm not really moving around too much. I don't, you know, you don't get overheated. You don't get dehydrated. Longer. You can stay in suit longer. So, Although Saturday night was pretty brutal with the humidity. Boy, I was sweating my butt off that night. You know, like, why? It's only like 60 degrees out. Why does it feel like 120 degrees?
Oh, yeah, humidity.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, well, whenever I hear humidity, I always think to growing up in Corpus Christi.
You know. Yeah, I like Corpus, though.
Well, that's because you only go like 4 days out of the year.
I'd like to go more often.
That's your boggle.
That's my boggle?
Yeah.
Okay. You just don't like the ocean, Mr. Bear.
No, I really don't. I'd rather go to a lake or a river and go camping. You know, hence the impetuous for this trip. You know, well, that and about ready to shoot somebody at my job, so.
Yeah, I was getting that same way.
Yeah, but you, it's more of a school thing, though.
Well, yeah. Well, your work isn't bad as the hours are long and you don't get a day off. I mean, it's 7 days straight. School, work, school, work, school, work. Mm-hmm. Moving on.
Well, actually, I don't think we have much else to talk about, really. I mean, we've hit most of the main points.
So we can go to Dairy Queen now.
Yes.
Yes, we go to Dairy Queen. Oh, it's not even 9 o'clock yet. We're doing awesome. We're doing awesome. We covered everything. But it's a good con.
Yeah.
Going back to the subject, it's a good con.
Like I said, a few minor little issues. You know, be sure you bring some, you know, something to hold you over when the meals run late.
If you want alcohol, bring it.
I remember because that was like the first thing you mentioned when you got here. Before we left, I was like, oh man, I forgot the alcohol.
Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, I'm not even a heavy drinker. It's just the fact that I knew I'd probably do a little bit of drinking, and I knew everything in that tiny little town is ridiculously expensive, which we found out to be true.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I'm surprised the dollar burgers weren't dollar burgers. I mean, you know.
And the snozzberries smell like snozzberries.
Yeah, there's just little things here and there. I mean, it's to be expected. It's a small town. You're at a little park, and you know, those things you're going to be without. Little creature comforts here and there. You know what was actually quite impressive were the beds. They upgraded the beds compared to what they were beforehand. The mattresses, yeah.
It was nice because...
Even though you had a green Care Bear staring you down all night long. And what were you doing on a top bunk? Seriously.
Dude, that was all they had left. That was all that was left. I mean, I had to take what I could get.
And I would have died laughing if I heard this, you know, 3 a.m. And just look over, and the top bunk has collapsed onto the bottom bunk.
You know, dude, in all honesty, I was worried about that. I mean, I weigh 275 pounds, okay? Mm-hmm.
And I think the weight limit on those are probably like...
Well, we know it's at least 225. We know it's at least 275.
Now, you know? Yeah. But you look at the frames of those things, and I was like, well, I could probably hold 200 pounds easy. 225.
What's Eduardo doing climbing on the second bunk?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's the ladder. Every step going out as he goes up. What is that? The metal bar is hitting the ground.
No, because I move a lot when I sleep. I'm kind of a wiggler, so that.
Yeah, I noticed that. I could hear the and the bed, you know, like just the the metal frame creaking, and I was like, "Oh, I know who that is."
Oh boy.
And that's another itty bitty complaint too. Is this the people that come in and have no respect?
Oh, the drunkies at 3 a.m.
They weren't drunk. They're just stupid. I mean, they're fursuiters coming in. They've already kind of desuited, so they can see. And then they go and flip the lights on with half the people asleep. At least half that room was already asleep. Mm-hmm. And they're just like, doo 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 doo. We're gonna desuit, and I walk over and shut the light off. And they're like, yay! And I'm like, yeah, that sucks to be you.
Yeah, because I don't even think we turned the light on when we came in.
Mm-mm.
Because I had my flashlight, my lightsaber, old school flashlight,
and that's all we needed.
Yeah, I flipped it on, pointed it toward the ceiling so that it wouldn't, you know, shine anybody's face, and that was enough for everybody to, you know, get settled in and dressed and.
The thing is, we're walking around in the dark. It's not like it's a well lit room, so your eyes are already adjusted.
Yeah.
So there was no reason to turn the light on.
Yeah, exactly. Like I said, the flashlight did us fine, and you know, and no, as far as I could tell, nobody was disturbed by it. So.
I was disturbed when they turned the lights on. Dude, that was like
I vaguely like remember it. Didn't I? Must have been out by then because
I said some choice words.
See, I don't remember that. I kind of remember the light turning on, but then I think I like I said, I was either too wiped out or it just didn't register.
Yeah, I was tired. I wanted to sleep, and I knew I was going to have to get up early for, you know, to get the heck out of there.
Yeah, get out of Dodge.
Yeah, and that was just like...
Oh, hell no.
Yeah, that was one of those moments. I was like, all right, bring it on.
Into each con, a little drama must fall.
I don't think that was any drama, though. You know what, I think...
Well, you gotta work for something.
Yeah. I do have to say, I definitely want to keep bringing RC trucks up there. That was kind of fun.
That was a lot of fun. Until they started complaining. Hey, man, kicking rocks and dirt up on everybody, dude.
I showered. Man, when I first took the truck out, I was showering people with mud. That was so much fun. They're like, hey, wow, that's a cool truck. I was like, that's so funny. I just showered them with mud, and they're like, oh, that's a cool truck.
It was cool though. I think hauled some ass.
Yeah.
You know, I still had the video of the dead guy by the campfire.
As the lunar rover approaches the dead alien body. That was so funny.
Yeah, they splashed water on him later.
Well, they popped that water balloon on him or something. Do you know who I am? I'm like, no, you're apparently a nobody who sleeps in the middle of a freaking fire pit. And who gives a crap who you are? You just got doused by a water balloon. All in good fun. If you're there, it's fair game.
Yeah, because that's where they were holding the water balloon fight.
Yeah.
If you're inside the circle, then you're going to get...
Yeah, you're lucky it wasn't me. I would have stuck the water balloon in a freezer for a while and then chunked it at him. I mean, that's stuff I used to do as a kid. I was like, what's this? I'm going to stick these 10 water balloons in here and let them freeze for a few hours. And oh, they won't know what hit them. I used to do the same in winters, you know, like snowballs. Stick those in the freezer for a while. Ooh, you're a nasty impact. It's like a softball hitting somebody's face.
Ooh, damn. I know not of the snow of which you speak, good sir.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You're going to have to go to a con up in the winter. Show you this miracle known as snow.
Actually, I have seen it once.
Mm-hmm. I miss snowboarding.
And here's the awesome thing. I saw it in Corpus Christi, Texas.
Of all places.
Yeah. Yeah, we had a freak snowfall back in 2009. On Christmas Eve, no less. Mm-hmm. In my hometown, we had 6 inches.
Cool.
So, neener.
Mm. You realize how off subject we're getting right now.
That's fine. That's why we have editing.
Yes. We could be a dairy queen right now.
Okay, well, let me go ahead and just close out, and then we'll go.
Yeah, sure.
Oh, he's hungry.
No. We can go for another 15 minutes, but it'll be...
No, we got nothing else to talk about.
We could talk about upcoming cons.
Like?
RealmsCon, my favorite con.
Oh, we'll do one of those later.
Okay.
We'll do a pregame.
We'll do a pregame for that, or San Japan or something.
Oh, or both.
Mm-hmm.
We'll see.
Yeah. Hey, I want to do more of this on the mic thing.
I knew you were going to like it.
The press is like my mic. Mike, your mic. Yes, I love you, Mike.
Yeah, the mic.
Oh, Lordy, what have I created?
A monster. I don't know.
Just a little one.
Just a little monster.
All right, folks, I think that's going to do it for episode number 26 of Con Talk, and so... On behalf of myself and my co-host, WolfBoy, thank you for listening and have a good one.